Online advertising is an enormous and lucrative market, with digital ad expenses being valued at billions of dollars. The truth is that we all expect a free web when we visit websites, and digital advertising is what keeps the web free for the users. Due to the sheer magnitude of the web and the millions of visitors, the ad ecosystem has shifted towards a programmatic model. The problem is that programmatic advertising is so complex with so many intermediaries that it enables bad actors to abuse it. In this work, we present ad laundering, a novel ad fraud technique that allows bad actors to conceal the true origin of ad inventory and trick advertisers into paying for low-quality ad slots. Using ad laundering, bad actors are able to conceal copyright-infringing content from most people and only show it to specific users. When ordinary users or even security experts visit the website directly, they will be served with legitimate and benign content. However, when a user is redirected to the same URL by a partner website, they get access to concealed illicit content. Advertisers are tricked into paying for ad slots next to illicit content, even though they think they are advertised next to benign content. We focus on anime, manga, or piracy websites and discover two techniques that bad actors use to implement ad laundering. We show how advertisers end up paying for low quality and fraudulent ad placements while having their ads appear next to content that might hurt their brand. Unfortunately, this technique is able to deceive even extremely popular brands and legitimate ad networks such as Google and Amazon. We discover that most users visit these websites to consume illicit content, but there are still some unsuspected visitors not aware of the illicit operation. Our findings suggest that ad laundering websites attract millions of visitors and are able to generate dozens of thousands of dollars on a monthly basis. For more information about the methodology of our work, as well as detailed description of our findings, you are encouraged to read our paper, published at the Web Conference 2024. Thank you.